Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to start. We have a very full program, so I will definitely have to skip a couple slides. I know this already. Financial disclosures, I have to skip it. Expectation on refractive cataract surgery, I would say on cataract surgery, old days are gone. Wanted something to see afterwards. We have now the implication that people want to see more. They want to be treated by, they're also not the cataract, but also the refractive error. In order to do this, we need more precise measurements because the visual acuity after cataract surgery depends on the intraocular lens and the power calculation. And of course, we have two variables, corneal power and axial length. And the AXL from Pentacam is a device which has actually corneal power measurements and axial length in one device. And you can see here all what is possible with this. I don't go through this in detail, but you have to see this yourself if you want to take all the advantage of this. The most important thing is what we have over the last year seen, anterior and posterior corneal surface measurements, and the role of the posterior cornea has been evaluated. And there are some measurements which are possible. Doing this, slit scan, imaging, Scheimpflug, optical coherence, light reflective, analogous to keratometry, and we imaging here are focusing on the Scheimpflug imaging. Now the tomographer are here. We see, we produce an image from the anterior segment, and the anterior segment is then distributed in this map, which gives you a lot of information. If you look at the map of the anterior chamber, I go to this, is in accordance with the Snell's law in order to produce our information. You see here a corneal power map, different views on the same eye, tangential, sagittal MAC, and total corneal refractive power. And the main thing is, on the right side, you take into consideration also the posterior surface and the anterior surface, of course, like in the two on the left side. Just here from the Pentacam, to demonstrate this to you in this slide, you have basically a keratometry measurement which gives you, for example, in this case, a difference between a very low number, and you have here a total corneal refractive power of the same value, and if you see the difference is only 0.3 diopters in K-SIM and the total corneal refractive power. And this can be different according to the outcome. Very quickly, corneal power, axial length, and IOL calculation. We did a study on the keratometry versus total corneal refractive power analysis. We did 5 device measurements, and we looked at the measurement of repeatability. Not to bore you too much, these were the outcome, but the SIMK, the Scheimpflug SIMK measurement showed the highest repeatability in this study we did publish in the Journal of Cataract and Refractive Surgery. And you see here the outcome again in detail. I think the time doesn't allow to go into this. The sources of errors in measurement are crystalline lens, posterior cornea, and retina. And the outcome on 3 studies, the first was done by Ho in 2009, I believe, then the corkscrew, we did also study. We found the same amount of the posterior measurement of 0.3 diopters negative numbers. Here's our IOVS paper, which highlighted this. These were 3,800 eyes. We looked at all these measurements in total corneal refractive power. And this is the most interesting slide, and I would like to go through this. If the anterior cornea showed with the rule astigmatism, then most of the time the posterior cornea was with the rule. If you had oblique anterior, you find a variety. There were 18% actually of oblique, and then there was also some against the rule. And if you look at the against the rule cases, you found that 18% were against the rule, only 18% of those patients, and the residual 59 were actually with the rule. So if you have eyes with against the rule, you always have to take care. So again, here this measurement, I already showed this 2 diopters difference between SIMK and the total corneal refractive power, very good. But if you have this case where you have SIMK of 0.1 and total refractive of 1 diopter, then you have to make a decision on how do you treat your astigmatism. Axial length. Now this comes into play with this machine because you have axial length in the machine. We use now as a gold standard optical coherence interferometry, which the the techniques are there, and the Oculus machine has actually this axial length measurement incorporated. You can see here the slides, how this is done. And of course, the calculation is done in a routine basis. Here, axial length is done in combination with the corneal measurements. I would like to summarize this just here. You can see here the machine on that right side. We published a paper in AJO looking at the difference between IOL Master 500, 700, and the Pentacam doing these axial length measurements. You can see here the outcome, devices, the two IOL Masters and the Pentacam AXL. And if I summarize this prospective case series of 79 eyes, the outcome actually demonstrated, we did Bland-Eltmann analysis, and what we found overall is, and I go to the summary slide, is that with this measurement, we found that the axial length was pretty good. I think this is a summary slide. No significant difference was found for the axial length measurement, favorable limits of agreement, and no significant difference with the comparison, comparing in terms of keratometry and ACD measurements. And the vector analysis of corneal astigmatism also showed no significant difference between these devices. So very good information for us. So conclusion, we need Scheimpflug measurements showing high repeatability. We found there is no difference for the axial length measurement to establish biometers. And therefore, the next step is IOL calculation. IOL calculation is done here, which is actually very obvious and very logical. Once you have a device which can take anterior and posterior measurements and axial length, then you go to IOL calculation because you have everything now in one device. And Oculus has actually done this. So you take calculation. Here's one of our speakers, the Savini toric calculator, for example, and you come up directly with an IOL, which gives you the power and also the spherical power and also the power of the toricity. And this is done in the IOL printout, which I showed here, and just a couple slides from this measurement. Take a look yourself. I think this is really the model. The take-home message: Scheimpflug measurements show high repeatability of corneal power evaluation, no significant difference between the Pentacam AXL and the established biometers for measurement of axial length, and the Pentacam allows IOL calculation incorporating the posterior surface, which is the total corneal refractive power if you count both together, and the posterior astigmatism. And I think this is our next step because we will have one device which does both, which we usually have to combine. Thank you.